Welcome back to another video, guys. Sorry I've been MIA. I've been MIA because, long story short, this video was actually recorded at the end of August when the game first came out. I uploaded it, but the audio portion never coupled with the video portion for whatever reason. So obviously I couldn't upload it. You wouldn't be able to hear anything. And I decided to go ahead and re-upload it maybe a week and a half, 2 weeks later, but I never got around to it because I was playing the game and I noticed that they didn't have one of the most basic cover for checks in the game, and that really set me off. I just didn't want to play anymore. Doesn't matter if I win, doesn't matter if I lose. If you don't have like the most basic checks in the game, that really set me off, and I was just like, I don't feel like dealing with these developers this year. They're just so horrible. I made it worse because it was like that basic check was in Madden 21. So it's like the game comes out and it's not like you don't even have the most basic check that was in your game last year. It just didn't even make any sense to me. So I think it was cover four palms. If you don't know, obviously just hang around. My videos is all about that type of stuff. You'll know what I'm talking about. But the cover four palms check when you're playing against trips formations, to where you have both outside receivers X'd out, and then you have the bubble over the number two and the number three, was not in the game when the game first came out, and that just made me kind of furious. And I'm like, I don't want to deal with this anymore. So that's why I just have not been playing Madden at all. I finally got around back to playing it about a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, and my love for football kind of dragged me back into this thing. It got rekindled because obviously we have no more football left to watch in regards to the NFL. The Super Bowl is over. So I was fumbling around different strategies, looking up stuff, and just one turn went from there, and I'm like, hey, why not go back to playing Madden, check it out. And here we are. I love making this type of content, and hopefully you guys love to deal with my videos. So I'm still on the PS4. I plan on getting to the PS5 for the next Madden that drops. So I didn't get a PS5 because I had nothing to play. I wasn't playing Madden this year, so I'm like, what's the point of even getting a PS5? But now that I'm playing, I'm like, you know what? Let me go ahead and get a PS5. But I had no idea it was still hard to get one. So I definitely look forward to getting one before the next Madden drops, and my next set of videos on the next Madden will be on next gen, okay? But as of right now, the videos for Madden 22, the videos I make for this year will be on Madden 22 until the next Madden drops, okay? So, word to the wise there. Anyways, let's go ahead and start this video. This video is on another passing concept. Please forgive me because I recorded this way early on in the year, so when I press play and go through these slides, I have to kind of rekindle my memory, knowing where I was going with each slide. Okay, so if you know my channel, you should know that we're all about reading a defense. Obviously we can throw in some progression reading, but pre-snap reading is very important, and you should know the sequence by now because I pretty much say it in almost every video. And that sequence is 4-2-2-0. 3-1. Okay. Those of you who don't know what this is, I don't care what defense you're running in the game. If you have 600 different defensive plays in your defensive playbook, when you select one, it will fall under one of these six different shell coverages. This is two zone. This is two man. Okay. So always remember this: 4-2-2-0-3-1. And the reason why this is very good is because now instead of you trying to pre-snap read 650 different defensive play calls that can be called by your opponent, you really only need to think of six different shell coverages because they all share, a two zone with a blitz, and a Tampa 2 may have subtle differences to it, but some of the weaknesses are eerily similar, right? So if you know the weaknesses of two zone, you can build from that in attacking a two zone with a strong side back or a blitz, that sort of thing, right? So learn the weaknesses of each one of these shell coverages and then build from there. You don't start from the end of the tunnel and work backwards, right? That's how you'll never understand, the basic weaknesses of any defense, right? So if I know the weaknesses of two man when it's played right, and then I see my opponent utilize like the, you know, the weak side safety, and he turns him into, you know, a flat defender. Well, because I know the weaknesses of two men, I know the weaknesses that he has created with making that difference in that defense. So he's strengthened the defense in one area, but he's opened up another weakness somewhere else, because we understand the weaknesses of two men in general, right? That's why it's very important. Learn the weaknesses of all six of these shell coverages and build from there, and you'll become a powerhouse when it comes to understanding where you should attack, where is the weakness, where is he strong, even after he makes, you know, subtle adjustments to whatever defense he calls. Okay, so this is for cover four zone. Also, under each one of these, there are like variants to it. So you got like cover four palms, you got cover four man match, and then you have like cover four drop zone. In the NFL, obviously, there probably are around 10 to 15 more variants under cover four, but hey, we're playing Madden and these guys suck. Okay, if you're a Madden fanboy, just like, I don't want to be rude. So cover two zone, like you got Tampa, and then you have like soft squat coverages with blitzes. Cover two man in Madden, they have like no variance at all under two man, again, because these guys are horrible. So like a variant under two man would be like cover five cougar. Maybe I'll get into that in another video. This video is always getting long with me talking. Cover zero, cover three, like you have man match. Cover three, you have spot drop. Cover three sky, you have cover three cloud, cover three buzz, that sort of thing. So that's what I mean by variance. But again, if it's under the umbrella of three, they share a lot of the same weaknesses. So it's good to understand the weaknesses of cover three before you drop down to each variant, right? All right, so I believe the first passing concept we went over was double slants, and that's a good this is a good passing concept you can run against double high. Oh, this is the double high side, and this is the single high side. Single high safety, you get cover three or cover one. Double high, you get cover four, cover two zone, cover two man, cover zero. Again, someone came in one of my videos and said, oh, you know, cover zero isn't double high. I know that. I just think it's easier to group it this way because I don't want three different subsections where you have double high, single high, no high, and no high only has this, you know, cover zero under it. It's just better to do it this way. 4-2-2-0-3-1, easier to remember. Double high, single high. Okay, double slants, good to run against double high. Y stick, we like to run it against single high. Levels, we like to run it against double high. Smash is more of a cover two zone type of beater. I would not recommend that against cover four, really not even two man, unless you have a wide receiver who's good at getting a release off the line of scrimmage in the slot, or whoever's running the corner, or whoever's running the route down the turkey hole, right? Snag is good against single high. Salem is really just good against almost any zone, especially spot drop zones. Hoss is good against single high, okay? And today we're going to go over our new concept, the Yankee passing concept, and this is a concept that is actually pretty good against single high. So this is the point where we're going through slides that I don't remember putting together, so now I'm just going on the fly. So hope you enjoy. So the Yankee concept, basically what it is, it's really a two-man route. Obviously, you can tether one of the routes with another passing concept underneath. Obviously, we're going to get into that. But basically, you have a deep over route from coming from one side of the formation, and like a deep post pattern from the opposite end of that formation. And you'll notice from these stills that I got from the internet that they tend to bring the wide receivers in on reduced splits. And it's really good against single high defenses. You also tend to see this type of route concept tethered with like play action. So, you know, like in cover three zone, you know, you got these backers who are in zone and they see that big play action with all of these players inside. You don't have a lot of players releasing downfield. You get them to draw up, and you can open up the window in between the second and third level for that over route. And when that over route is crossing across the field, if you got that deep high safety who wants to bite on that route, then you got this deep post pattern that you can throw over the top. And remember, in cover three zone, this corner would be playing, expecting help from his deep high safety. So if that deep high safety drives on that over route, that's when you got that big play potential of that deep bomb you can throw on the post. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, Yankee concept two receiver route over post combination. I went over that. Play action, blah blah blah. Deep over, yep. Okay, here, I believe it's the Texans. They got the same concept going, so it looks like they bring him in motion. Got the play action here. Goes to the flat. We got a little over and deep post pattern, and you see they're in single high. So again, you see a team, and this was back when the Seahawks, remember, they were a hardcore cover three team with Sherman and the rest of the boys. So you would come into the game with, single high beaters, things that are really good against single high, right? Now, obviously, you would package something like this, the Yankee concept, with your passing plays to attack the, Seattle Seahawks. If you're going against a hardcore two-man team, then you may look for other things to attack it. So here's some more play art. Not to say that this isn't good against two-man, but this is just an ideal concept to run against single high. So here, I got a video shot here, and as you can see, they're in single high. And I don't remember this slide at all, but let's go ahead and watch it. Play action. He actually play action the wrong way. The back went the opposite way. And there he threw the over route. Throws the ball. If you want to go back. So let's watch the backers. Watch these three guys. Spread out. He did the play action. So you got this little window. They didn't bite as much as you would like, but the hold was good enough. You got this little window here that you can fit with this over route. And as we see, the safety doesn't drive on it. So that leaves an opening to throw this little over pattern here. He actually scores on that too. So yeah, with him following that, I mean, they can disguise it, but it's probably cover one man. I'm not gonna dive deep into the tape to figure what they were running. It looks like they were matching at a particular depth down the field into man. But they got torched there. Here we are. We got same deal. Almost looked like cover one there. Packers. This might be the. I think I remember that. I think this was a flea flicker almost. But obviously you're gonna have the over route and the deep post pattern here. Let's see. Was this a flea flicker? Let's see. Yeah, it was. You see the safety? You see how he drove up? And now he's caught. He can get caught in no man's land. He might recover, but I mean, they have no chance here. This guy's coming on the over route. I mean, it's just wide open. All right, so I had that written in there to showcase that the Yankee passing concept. You know how you can go through the passing concept folders of Madden to find a passing. Maybe your opponent is running, cover two zone, so you can go to the smash passing concept to find all of the plays with the smash passing concept in your offensive playbook and select it, go through the plays. They don't have Yankee passing concept in their folder because they are what they are. But if I recall correctly, I believe they did have it in the shot folder. Let's see if I did that here. So here I'm going through it. Spacing, six, five, mesh, slot cross, Texas. I was checking these folders to see if they were in there. So here we are. We're in shot. And you see this right here? deep play action, deep post pattern, over pattern. That's the Yankee passing concept, right? So let's go through the folder. This looks like some, I mean, looks like a, you know, a dig pattern, but it's crossing over the middle of the field. You got big time play action, you got a deep post pattern. Same thing. You're trying to manipulate, you know, single high safety. If they bite on that deep dig, you can throw the post, play action, pull the linebackers up to open up the window for the deep dig, etc. Same thing here. Play action, got an over pattern, deep post, and you also got drag underneath. Obviously, see, this is the shot play folder, so they're going to have all types of stuff in the shot play. They don't have a folder dedicated to the Yankee passing concept, right? So this doesn't look nothing like Yankee to me. It's a double post pattern play action. This is almost like a curl flat with an over route, and this is the sluggo seam play that hasn't worked properly in Madden for 25 years. You would think that they would, like, work on their game. But whatever. So I'm just warning you, like, if you go
one of the best
play folder to find your Yankee passing concepts, you're gonna find a whole bunch of other stuff in there that doesn't, you know, that's not Yankee passing concept, because that's their shot play folder. Right, they don't have a folder dedicated to the Yankee passing concept. So now I remember this slide. This slide was to show you a video of the Cardinals. They ran a Yankee passing concept in this video. They're going to talk about it. They don't talk about it being a Yankee concept. I think it was Buda Baker who was being interviewed about the top players, and they were talking about this guy here, Hopkins. And Hopkins actually ran, he was running the post pattern than the concept. The opposing team, I believe, was running cover three or cover one, and they threw it right to the post where it should have been intercepted. And he's just so good. He caught the pass over both defenders, and that's what this video was about. But I wanted to showcase them running the passing concept.
12 receivers in this league. K1 threw a post route in cover three. And if anyone who knows football, you should never be able to throw a post route in cover three. D-Hop just got up, caught it between two guys.
And Murray's going to heave it deep downfield, and that ball is caught. Hopkins.
Okay, that's a little worrisome. Because obviously we know the Cardinals played in the playoff game, and there's been some, I guess, some rumbling about the play of their quarterback. And now when I look back on this, it's like, when you watch this play, he should not have thrown this ball. So, you know, maybe I'm reading too much into it, but, you know, it could be a fundamental weakness of his game. I got to look more into his game. Into Murray, but let's go ahead and play it.
With two defenders there
in cover three, the safety take the crosser, the corner replaces. Kyler Murray throwing it up, giving them a chance. And Hop doing what he do best, man. That's what makes DeAndre Hopkins. The safety take.
Okay, so yeah, it looks like some form of cover three, right? Deep middle safety, deep third. You got your linebackers underneath, and you can see him. He's in the play action. He's at the mesh point with the running back. Now what happens here in cover three, like when you get this deep over, they can check. The safety can replace the corner. So when he runs this over route and this guy runs the post pattern, now this guy is playing, you know, outside leverage because he has inside help. But I mean, it's with that technique, it's impossible for him to cover the over pattern, pretty much giving the inside away right here on that over route. So, I mean, what the defense checks to, at least in this video, is the safety replaces the corner. So he has far more of an opportunity to make a play on this over route. He's not out leveraged like the corner, and the corner replaces the safety. Now, so just think, I mean, it's just a pretty decent wrinkle cover three has. You know, at least the way that they play it, I'm pretty sure this is pretty basic for NFL defenses. So I guess we can check Madden and see if they, you know, have this coded in. And I'm pretty sure you know the answer to that question already. So let's go ahead and watch this video. Watch how the safety replaces the corner. And the corner, the safety cuts and the corner replaces the safety to play deep middle. And you'll see he'll throw this ball to the deep post. Actually, both of them were covered because of this cut action with the safety. The over pattern wasn't really open, and the post pattern was almost bracketed, really, with him replacing the safety playing deep middle and this corner playing outside. So he had outside in on this route, and he just threw it up anyway. So it was actually kind of like a bad read from the quarterback. You throw this ball 80 times, you know, it's a knockdown ball or an interception, you know, or a bad play probably about 70 times, right? But, you know, he has one of the best receivers in the game.
The cross or the corner places. Kyler Murray throwing it up, giving them a chance. And Hop doing it.
Defenders there.
In cover three. The safety take the cross or the corner, replaces. Kyler Murray throwing it up, giving them a chance. And Hop doing what he do best, man. That's what makes DeAndre Hopkins DeAndre Hopkins. The safety take the cross or the corner, replaces. Kyler Murray throwing it up, giving them a chance. And Hop doing it.
With two defenders there.
All right, so obviously we know that they don't have a folder dedicated to Yankee, but let's try it out. Let's try the Yankee concept against a cover three. I think I did cover three sky here. And we got reduced splits too, right? Typically when you see Yankee concept being ran, it'll be with reduced splits. I believe I said that earlier. And obviously they tether it, I would say 99% of the time, with play action. Again, because you see it's a two-man route combination. You're trying to get this heavy run fake action to draw up the linebackers to, again, open up this window in between the second and third level so you can throw it over. And then if the safety bites on that, you got inside leverage on this deep post, right? Also, the passing game is all about, you know, vertically, horizontally stretching defenders. So you want to tether routes together and package them in a way in which we can add another route to this to optimize the play. So as you can see, this play action, the running back can leak into the flat, and then we get a high-low read on this side of the field. So let me thin this out a little bit. So think about it. You know, we run the play action. Let's say the linebackers don't really bite on it, right? So we get our curl to flat player, your hook to curl, your hook to curl, curl to flat, deep third, no, deep third. Let's say this window behind these backers doesn't open up. So, you know, you don't have a window to throw to. It would be a really tight window in between here that maybe you can get it in, but, you know, just for the sake of the video, or for a passing play, it's just not open for whatever reason. They don't bite. Running game, they're not buying it, right? So the second window isn't open, and obviously the safety doesn't bite on the over pattern, so the post isn't open. So, I mean, once you hit the final step in your drop, what you can do is, as we see in this play, you have a high-low read on this side of the field. So if they're in cover three zone, you see this curl flat player? Obviously, the deep third is going to be drawn up the field with this deep post pattern. And then you'll have the curl flat player defending, you know, this area of the field. He can never be right, right? If he jumps the flat pattern, then we can throw the over pattern here, right? If he stays in the window of the over pattern, then we can throw it underneath to our flat and get upfield. So you can see how deadly this play can be in against cover three. Single high in general, right? Because it's really hard to kind of cover an over pattern in man-to-man coverage, right?
180!
Snap the ball. And the safety's going to butt. Nope. So I'll just go ahead and spoil it for you. The safety, if it's the computer, will never bite. Ever. Because we all know what Madden is. You just drift off in the la-la land. They don't make plays in the secondary, like the deep middle safety in cover three, you know. And it's kind of sad too, because it's like you want to play that cat and mouse game. Like, you, if you're the defense, you want him to make more plays, you want him to jump, you know, the over pattern occasionally, etc., way far more than what it does in a game. It's 0% of the time he will jump it with this post pattern behind, right? But if that cat and mouse game was in the game, you know, you would get interceptions as the defense. right? And on the flip side of that, it will reward higher skilled players with reading defenses post-snap. Post-snap, you snap the ball, you do the play action, he jumps the over, and then you throw the post right over the top, right? It would reward the higher skilled players for pre-snap and post-snap reading, you know? And then maybe you can ask the safety, hey, whenever we're in cover three and you see the Yankee concept, I want you to jump the over pattern. Because maybe you get a read on your opponent. He always throws the over pattern. He never post-snap reads the deep middle safety. He just throws it, you know what I mean? So he can overcut it. But in retrospect, I mean, we saw how the defense played against the Cardinals in that last video. They played it perfectly. You really, yeah, you know, jump that. Well, how about you just cut it? You take over for this corner, and this corner plays over the top. I mean, it's just like the perfect, you know, check and cover three against the Yankee concept. So obviously we're going to see that in Madden, right? Well, to spoil you, no, you'll never see it, right? So as we can see, we can throw that over pattern, right, against cover three because we get a high-low read on that side of the field. But, I mean, that's really it. There's no dynamic play with the Yankee concept against cover three in the game of Madden. There just isn't. Okay, against cover one, you can throw the cover one, you know, the over pattern and et cetera. But don't ever hinge on the deep middle safety biting on that over pattern. So I started, this was way back in August, remember? I started making a V-book for the LA Rams. It's crazy that this was way back in August and the LA Rams ends up, they win the Super Bowl, right? So I was going to do a Rams playbook. So these are why these slides are going over plays from the Rams where I started like a mini scheme with the Rams. Obviously, I didn't do an ebook on it, you guys, but might as well go over it where we utilize the Yankee concept. So here we see it here, one of the plays. Well, no, this isn't the Rams playbook. These are a bunch of plays that I gathered from the game of Madden where you can see the Yankee concept being run, right? This one, they decided not to have a flat pattern in it. They want heavy play action here with just a two-man route. Really not a big fan. I mean, I guess you can utilize that. So here's where I took the Rams playbook where I saw some pretty unique stuff. And I started using the Rams playbook in the beginning of the year. And I was going to make a V-book on the Rams, but obviously that's changed. I'm not going to do the Rams. I may do a different ebook. But here they have an empty set. We have like a motion from the outside receiver, and he goes to the flat. And then we have our over pattern here, and we have our deep post, right? So we have our Yankee concept there from a unique formation, an empty set, which is pretty cool. But obviously you want to have... You want to have plays that look the same that can run, you know, differently. So we actually do have the jet sweep from that same action, right? And then we also have the fake jet where he goes in motion and we toss it off to the reverse motion from, well, not motion, but the other side. I don't remember this this formation. So here it is, gun, eagle, H tight. So I think it's the running back that gets it on that touch pass fake jet. I wonder if it's a receiver, but I guess we'll see. And I was going to do these package plays to start off the playbook. So let's show some game action of the Yankee concept.
The Titans off it.
So look, we get single high. We get single high. And I'm like, you know, I think up to this point, he was running a lot of single high. And I'm like, hey, I can run this Yankee concept and we can throw this in the video. So I, lo and behold, I picked this, and here we go.
And set to begin the drive.
So we're going to do this play action, get a feel if it's cover one or cover three. Hopefully the backers pull up, open up the window for the over pattern, and once that happens, or if that happens, then we can read the safety. But in Madden, we don't ever have to read the safety unless it's the user, right?
And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to.
This offense set to begin.
I think he was a user here. Play action, draw him up, and think about the zones. curl flat. You're supposed to be, I'll put him in white, hook curl. So this is his area right here, right? Yeah, see, I don't remember.
The drive.
I'll have to watch this again, because he's got the second defender in way over. There's so many alignment issues with this. This is horrible. But again, I this is my first time going over the slide for like months.
The touchdown a moment ago, it's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game.
Yeah, he's all over the place. So that second defender in was a curl flat. Let's go back. He's the curl flat. He's the hook curl. Curl flat. This guy is just way out of position here.
No, it's back to a one-score game.
And because of that.
And it's him. So that's why this area of the field is just. And then it looks like, oh, he just brought him on a brusher. So curl flat, curl flat. I mean, this guy has this entire area to defend, and he bites on the play action. Draws up. This window is just wide open.
Pressure, because it's now a one-score game. They know this is where you need.
I mean, that's just textbook.
Need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that can
okay,
overrun.
Cover three match. So
on your team, you got to be
same deal. A lot of players, when they play cover three match, they turn it into a zone, right, to where it doesn't match at all, which to me doesn't make any sense. You might as well just play cover three.
Careful right here.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. Man, I just love
okay, single high.
Being in this stadium, so much history, tradition, so many great teams and games.
Okay, so I checked to single high beating offensive passing concept. This is the Hank concept, so I'll make another video on that.
And we're seeing a pretty good one.
Basically, with the Hank concept, he's going to come over the ball. He runs a flat pattern at 2 to 3 yards. He runs up and runs a curl pattern at about 12 yards. Curl pattern at about 12 yards, flat pattern at about 3 yards. And against cover three, you have your deep middle, deep third, or cover one man when they're in man, and you get your curl flats. Hook curl, guy looks like maybe curl flat. Maybe hook curl, who knows? So, your number one read is the over the ball tight end. If the linebackers are spread apart and he gets right in the middle, you just throw it right to him, right? Now, the read is if the linebackers squeeze on that play, the two hook curl defenders, whichever linebacker cheats in, so let's say the linebacker from this side, the hook curl defender, cheats on that throw, then you work the side that he came from. So you will work this side. And it's impossible for them to defend in cover three. And it's pretty difficult in cover one as well, as long as you have a receiver who can create separation. And what you do is you're just reading the curl flat to player. If he whitens for the flat, you throw the curl. If he doesn't whiten and he stays in the window of the curl, then you just throw the flat, right? He can never be right. So, you know, that's the basic of the Hank concept. Obviously, I'll make another video
right
for
now,
that
hotly contested in the third quarter.
So, look, he cheats in. He cheated in at first. I mean, this is, so you work this side. You look for the second defender in. That's this guy here. He's in the window, so he's wide open. I should have thrown it there. Let's see if I messed up. I did. So, yeah, I threw it. I mean, he was open. I would like to throw it more inside. Inside shoulder, so he can't get to it. Maybe I did in the game, but you know how the game is, where you kind of throw one way and it, I mean, just the smallest detail, you want it inside but it goes outside. You know what I mean? Little stuff like that can be the difference between a touchdown and an interception, right? So I would like to throw it inside, but he was still slightly open. He wasn't driving on the ball, but the right read there was to go to the flat.
Now this one over the middle into the hand.
Look at that, 14 for 15, 160 yards, two TDs.
Hands of his tight end complete.
Looks like I was running like a methodical.
Contain him to just four, second down.
Check the Hank concept again.
Out of the gun, Tanner.
He's cheating. So you work the cheater side. Look for the second defender in. There he is. You see how he widened? There's your throw.
Hill.
And I did.
Jones has it. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 41-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
So I went to, obviously, the jet sweep of this. So, you know, we can kind of, you know, anytime he saw this action behind the line of scrimmage, he wouldn't automatically think, oh, it's play action, that over pattern, etc. We want him to at least play honest at some point and respect this particular run. It's the whole point of having it packaged with the Yankee concept.
A strong running.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
I have no, I don't like checking to this at all.
From the 36.
But I'm pretty sure I'm probably looking for this this dig pattern here. So we got this little cross here. Hopefully hold up some of these linebackers, pull them up. Got the space here for that circle. I wonder if I went there.
Tannehill.
I did.
And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 22-yard line. The Titans get 14 yards there and move the chains as well.
Back to the Hank.
On first down.
And right here, when I saw him pick the deep middle safety, keep that in mind.
Now it's Tannehill.
Okay, through the over pattern.
He's driving over the middle. That's Ferkser. They'll contain him to just four.
I do vaguely remember this play.
Second down.
So, yeah, I remember. So here it is. We know in Madden, this computer, usually the user does not pick deep middle safety in cover three, right? So remember the play, the Yankee. We get the over and the post. And, you know, play action to draw up the linebackers, open up the space in between the second and third level. This is the second level with the linebackers and the corners. And in between that would be in front of the safeties, behind the, you know, the linebackers, etc. So pull them up, got that window. In real life, you're looking to attack this guy in that scenario because if he drives on the over pattern, we can throw right over the top for the post. I mean, it just looks beautiful, you know, a post pattern thrown in a game. You fooled the deep middle safety. But we know the computer will never drive on that route. So when I saw him pick this safety, I was like, wow, this is my time. He's been driving as a linebacker on play actions. He's been driving on the underneath route so I can throw the deep dig. He just drives on anything that's in front of him. So I can't believe he picked his deep middle safety in cover three. What's going to happen is, this is what I was thinking, I'm going to snap the ball. We're going to get this play action. Then we're going to have this over pattern coming right in front of him. He's going to drive on it, and I'm going to throw this post pattern. It's going to be beautiful. It's just art. And I got it. I'm recording, too. I can't wait, right? This is my moment. This is it.
Again, Tannehill.
It's there. He sat underneath. He didn't even defend the over pattern, but his post pattern is right there. And,
looking in.
Yeah.
Zone, but it's in.
So I believe I stopped recording there for obvious reasons. But as you can see, you know, we got the over pattern, we got the deep post pattern, we drew the safety up, and then of course Madden just gonna Madden you. So even in the occasion where one out of 1,000 times you get the scenario you want, where the deep safety is the user, because no one ever picks deep middle safety in cover three, and he actually, you know, overplayed the over. You know, out of that 1 in 100 times this happens, you're going to have, you know, the 60 out of 100 times that Madden screws you on the throw. You with, you know, superior skill, you made the right play, you pre and post snap read, you keyed the defender correctly, you made the right read, and the ball goes 60 yards, you know, into the stands, right? Meanwhile, your opponent just runs the same play over and over and over and over and over again, and your defenders are just clueless if you stick in the same defense and et cetera. There's so many gimmicks, and you know that's the thing I hate about Madden. It's like you got to work around it to figure out ways to answer problems that shouldn't exist if they just coded the game the way it should be coded, right? Like real life concepts and real life football answers. So I'll leave it at that. We got the Yankee concept in now. And these are the passing concepts we don't went over. Obviously, we got to get into the running concept plays, right? So you got like inside zone. You got inside zone split. You got outside zone. You got power. You got trap. QB read stuff. You got counter. Right, there's a whole bunch of stuff you can go over in running, so it's a lot of stuff to go over in football. I enjoy doing stuff like this, and hope you guys come back again.